clerk tells me that you can exercise your rights under Rule 2.14 of the court, which would mean you'd waive a trial here today. I'll ask the state to give me an offer of proof. In all likelihood, I would make a guilty finding, but you could appeal for a jury trial. Is that what you're saying there?
I'm not sure that I understand completely the specific point of that. The 2.14 reference eludes me.
Well, 2.14 is a district court, a circuit court rule that provides that if someone wants to waive their trial, they can do that. Now, we're going to conduct a trial in your case today, correct?
That wasn't my understanding, Your Honor. I'm sorry if I was mistaken in that.
And I can let the court know, when we were here, it was on September 30th, pursuant to the motion that I filed under the court.
Right, I recall, yeah.
I asked the court specifically to remind him that today is his trial date. Right. And the court did that. So he should have understood that today.
I recall that pretty well, that hearing, and recall that you were advised specifically what that trial date was, and that was today. So today is the date it was set for your trial today. If the clerk was wrong or misunderstood somebody, we'll get it ironed out right now.
That would be a bench trial, correct?
That would be a bench trial. But okay. You can waive that. You can say, I'm not going to ask for that trial. I'm going to waive my right to a trial, but I am going to appeal the outcome to the Superior Court upstairs, and I'm going to exercise my right to have a jury trial in this case.
Sure.
That's what the consequence of that would be. You understand that?
My desire and intention in this is to take this to a jury.
Okay, well that's one way to do it. That's the course you want to take today.
Well, I would like to get it in front of the jury in the fastest, easiest way possible.
That would probably be just as fast as having a trial, isn't it?
It's my understanding misdemeanor appeals take precedence on
you probably have to get a trial scheduled up there before you get one. Somebody getting a trial scheduled today, you're not doing it in March. You get yours before then, in all likelihood. Okay.
Yeah, that's fine, Your Honor. There's one more thing. When I leave here this morning, I'm going to have to go to the Superior Court office and finish filing the stalking petition against the alleged defendant in this case.
Well, that's up to you.
He continues to stalk me as recently as a few days ago. He stalked me at my home.
That's not in front of me as an allegation. If you want to perfect that allegation and file it upstairs, you have every right to.
Okay.
Okay.
Thank you, Your Honor.
That's up to you to do. Okay. Do you want Attorney Killam to make an offer of proof as to the facts she would have produced here today at trial?
That would be acceptable.
Okay.
And Your Honor, also, I understand that I have neglected to, and I need to correct this. I need to file a formal discovery request.
Well, that will be, we'll talk with Attorney Killam afterwards. One discovery request, who handles, is anybody assigned to misdemeanor appeals in the...
County
makes
office, no, it's
on a
case-by-case basis.
Okay, well, you can find out who gets the case assigned to, that you'll be dealing with different attorneys, okay? You're dealing with the different part of the county attorney's office.
Correct.
You file your discovery, but I would wait a week or two because they're not going to know anything about the case.
They won't have
any case to file on it.
We need to nail down exactly which evidence will and will not be presented.
That's not for me today. If you're reviewing that, you can file what are called motions in limine to try to make preliminary rulings on evidence. Each side is permitted to do that.
Yeah, I'm trying to explain, Your Honor, how I'm seeing this, what my difficulty is in understanding.
Well,
my
schedule three trials and a misdemeanor appeals?
They do.
Okay, so what will happen is in the Superior Court, they'll have to actually have a pretrial. And have a meeting in front of the judge, and you'll be able to iron out some of the purpose of that is to see what kind of problems and things are all kind of knotted up to try to undo those.
That sounds good, Your Honor.
All right. And I'd like to give you the offer of proof. Yes, Your Honor.
On Tuesday, May 20th, this year, 2014, was about 9:45 in the evening. Mr. Garret Ean was downtown on Main Street, squatting in the median across from Michelle's restaurant, facing east. He indicated that he was crouched down, chalking on the sidewalk. He indicated he heard the sound of fast footsteps behind him, felt the hand forcefully grab the back of his neck, clasping his skin and hair. He stumbled two or three steps forward and yelled, "Hey, let go of me." He had to drag him alongside the individual clasping his neck. The individual let go of him at the edge of the road. He continued walking east in an easterly direction. And at that time, Mr. Garret Ean observed that his attacker was Bradford Hutchingson. He had known him from previous interactions in the past. He had described a number of instances where where the defendant had essentially harassed him on occasion. So he knew of him. He did confront the defendant and asked him why he did that. The defendant indicated he didn't know who he was, pretended not to know him. And that was that. He didn't admit to Mr. Ean that he did it, but there was someone else in the area at the time. For the first information, Mr. Garret Ean did make a report. The following morning, it was roughly 1 a.m. or so, he went to the police department to talk about to Jason Thompson to report what I used to report. And Jason followed me and went to speak with Mr. Hutchingson. He did so. Mr. Hutchingson admitted that he was there and the interaction with Mr. Ean, but he didn't admit to assaulting him. Jason Thompson applied for an arrest warrant, which he didn't receive. And Steve Corey, Officer Corey, arrested the defendant on June 9th. He was about 11 or 9 at the police department. And he, after he read his Miranda rights, the defendant waved and did speak with him about it, just briefly. When confronted by Officer Corey whether he assaulted Mr. Ean, the defendant replied, he wasn't saying he never touched him. What he said was that there was contact. It was incidental, accidental, mutual. He then went on to say how the three Keene people had been harassing him and days after him. And that's the scene.
Anything you want to say? I realize you have a different version, but we're not here to try your case because you're waiting on opportunities. I just want to make sure the state has sufficient facts to prove the case beyond reasonable doubt, at least to my satisfaction, and they have. Do you have a recommendation?
Your Honor, the state, for the court's information, does have a criminal record. His most recent conviction are from 2006. He was convicted in February of 2006. He was bailed. He served 3 days. In May of 2006, he was convicted of harassment. He had a 60-day deferred sentence that was ultimately suspended. The court's information, or the state would recommend to the court for a sentence, the state sentenced him to 9 days in the House of Corrections, suspended for 2 years upon condition of good behavior. Upon the condition they did not have any contact with Garret Ean. I also ask that the court order a year of probation to serve and that treatment be ordered and comply with any treatment as ordered by probation. I think the court's familiar with Mr. Hutchingson. It's my understanding he's engaged in services in the community for his mental health.
You say probation to serve?
To serve, a year to serve. And the reason for that is just to simply monitor him within the community, make sure that he's complying with his mental health recommendations. The court's information that I mentioned when I was making my offer proof, this wasn't the first interaction he's had with Mr. Ean. Mr. Ean reported an incident where in February of 2013, where he approached Mr. Ean with a canister of pepper spray or mace issues from his face. When Mr. Ean asked him to stop, he tried to wrap his arm around his head, and this occurred in the parking lot.
Well, this is in support. We're not trying that case. This is just in support of a recommendation at this point.
This happened.
This is in support of a recommendation that you have no contact with Mr. Ean. That's all.
I would like that. Is that you made mutual?
I can't do that in this kind of case, no.
Okay.
And he also reported a couple of instances where.
All right. There's sufficient reason for the contact.
And the other thing is.
Is EAN?
EAN.
I want the no contact, Your Honor. I want that.
You got it.
And finally, I think probation is appropriate. I read several emails that I attached to a motion that I filed with this court order in this case. I think there's grounds to be concerned about his behavior, arguably it's concerning, and there were vague threats.
All right, I'm going to accept the state's recommendation here. So this is the sentence, although it's stayed because you're on appeal. So.
Thank you.
90 days of the House of Corrections suspended for 2 years on good behavior. Good behavior always means no felonies, misdemeanors, major motor vehicle violations. There are some additional conditions here. One is no contact with Mr. Ean. And look, up into your bail status in a second and probation for 1 year. So that sentence is stayed pending your appeal. However, your bail conditions remain in effect. And that the bail conditions just to remind you, have no contact with Mr. Ean. We had a P.O. Box 1860 in Keene for you. Is that still your address?
That's still correct, Your Honor.
Okay. You refrain from alcohol, narcotics, controlled substances. I know there are meds. We talked about them.
I continue to enjoy my sobriety, Your Honor.
You take your meds as required and no driving without a valid license. Those remain in effect. If you want any relief or modification of the bail orders, next stop is Superior Court to ask for that. But again, I give it a week or two to get all the paperwork filed and everything.
Those are acceptable conditions.
All right. You're all set then. Thank you.
Thank you, Your Honor. So we're done here today.
Done here, yes.
Thank you, Your
Honor. Now, if you change your mind, they'll tell you, if you want to change your mind about your appeal, they'll kick it back here on a remand. Okay? So in other words, if you decide you don't want to go forward with your jury trial, they won't let you waive a jury trial. You need to have your jury trial and you come back here.
Yeah.
Okay?
There's no playing around, in other words, is what you're telling me.
Right.
Okay.
And then I'll leave the other matter to talk about up to you to pursue.